B'shut v'rabotei, today it's the Shiva of Maran Tzadik Avchaim Kanivsky. Today, Baruch Hashem, last night before I left Eretz Israel, I went to the Beit Alamin, to the cemetery, to pray. It's very hard to believe what happened. He was one of the biggest tzaddikim of all time. He had no title. He was not Dayan, or Rosh Abidin, or Rosh Yeshiva. He was very far away from all this kavod. He was an avrech all his life. Can you imagine that? He could be the only chief rabbi of all the Jews in the world. He didn't want. All the Torah, every year, he will repeat the Torah. Every year, he will repeat the Shas, Babli, Yerushalmi. That was the life of Maran Alav HaShalom, Rav Chaim Kanivsky. And I don't know how the world can live without him. I mean, we have to get used to it. But it's a big loss. A big, big loss. There was a story that I read yesterday. Rav Rosh Shiva Porat Yosef, Rabbi Shalom, Hacham Shalom Cohen, he said that about 40 years ago, he went from Yerushalayim to Bnei Brak to buy the Kehilot Yaakov. The stapler, the father of Rav Chaim Kanivsky, his name was the stapler, he wrote a book, Yeshivish book, Yeshivad, a book that all the Yeshivot, they read it. And he went to buy the book from him. And he was shocked. He saw the stapler. He was a pussy. He was pushing, you know, the scarf. The scarf to be the sukkah, you put some palmier. Some palms, you know. From the tree, from the scarf. And he was an old man. So Rabbi Shalom, Cohen, he was shocked. He told him, Rabbi, what's this? What do you do? He said, well, sukkah. He said, but where's your son? Chaim, to help you. He said, my son, he studied Torah. I want to tell you, the Gemara said, if tomorrow Mashiach will come, and you will receive emails, you will hear Eliyahu HaNevi with the shofar calling you, come now, all of you, we're going to build the Beit HaMikdash. And that moment, you are studying Torah. What do? You stop from studying Torah to go to build the Beit HaMikdash, or you carry on to study Torah? The halacha is, you don't stop from studying Torah. The Beit HaMikdash, he can wait for you. That means that the Beit HaMikdash, the limud Torah, the study Torah is more than the Beit HaMikdash. No, more to build the Beit HaMikdash. A lot of people, the middle when the rab give a drasha, some people want to read another book, or Tehillim, or they have to stop. Torah always come first. So, and that, can you imagine? It was very hard for me to, this story that I heard yesterday, that I read yesterday, it shocked me. That means that an old man, a big tzaddik, one of the biggest tzaddikim of all time, the stapler, he will build the sukkah alone without the help of his son, because his son was studying Torah. He will not stop him from studying Torah. You know, my friend, the parasha of yesterday, we saw there that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave us food to eat and food not to eat. Kosher, not kosher. And I had a question in my mind. What did HaKadosh Baruch Hu need it to create not kosher food? I did not understand why. Why HaKadosh Baruch Hu would not only create to make our life a little bit easy. We don't need that there is a tariff. So we do that all the meat is kosher, and that's it. Why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Be'et Hashem, when Mashiach will come, everything will be kosher. They will not tumah anymore. And by the way, as well, I had a question. Why Shabbat? We know that Hashem created the world on 6 days. He said that. But why HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us Shabbat? Why we need it Shabbat? If Hashem he created the world on 6 days, that's it. We do 6 days a week. That's it. But why Shabbat? Not to do nothing. What was the reason? You know what the Benish Hai said? The Benish Hai said, when you look at the menorah, you have the menorah in front of you, you have 7 branches. 3 in the right, 3 in the left, 1 in the middle. The 3 in the left and the right, it's Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. The 3 branch on the left, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And the 1 in the middle is Shabbat. That means HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he did that all the brachot of the week will come on Shabbat. But why Shabbat? What was the purpose of us? Of course there is a reason. You know, my friend, you have to know one thing. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he wants to teach us that we have to be strong on our ta'avot. Usually we people, we invite this, we invite this, we want this, we want... HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he wanted that Am Yisrael will be some special people. They have to be strong. What to eat, what not to eat. For instance, a lot of times we are in the plane. We saw everybody eating whatever they want to eat. You are a strong man, you don't eat. You take a sandwich. You see, you are in first class or business class. You see everybody having a good meal. It's good. The Rambam said, we are not allowed to say this is no good. Oh, what a shame. He created it's good. It's good. Only Hashem he said, don't eat it, that's it. Hashem wanted us to be a man. To know how to control ourselves, how to control our eyes, what to see with our eyes, why not to see, what not to see, what to eat, what not to eat. Hashem, he wanted us to be mensch. And for doing that, you get a reward. So that's why Hashem, he gave us, this is tahor, this is not tahor, this is kasher, this is not kasher. Just that we should make a difference between this and this. Otherwise, just imagine that everything is kosher, everything. So we will not appreciate, we will get used to it. We will not appreciate, everything is kosher, yeah. The goyim, there is no need there by them. There is no need there. So always there is divorce by them. By Am Israel, because there is always this separation between man and woman, because she's nida, so she appreciates him more, he appreciates her more. Hashem, he gave us that we have to know how to control ourselves. You have to get angry, control yourself. Don't be angry. You want to speak Lashon Hara, control yourself. Not to speak Lashon Hara. Look at what I, my friend, Nadav v'Abihu. What happened to them yesterday, the parasha of yesterday? What happened to them? It's when they saw the ash, the fire, came from the Shamayim to eat the sacrifice. What they did? Suddenly, they did not ask nobody. They went inside and they did what they did. And Hashem punished them. And then Hashem, what he said? Well, cry them. My question is, why have to cry them? If they deserve to be punished, so they are punished. If they don't deserve to be punished, so why Hashem did what he did? My friend, Nadav v'Abihu, what they did, that was, for them maybe it was good, but for us, we learn not to get used to what they did, because otherwise, everybody can come to the Beit HaMikdash, then it's going to be a problem. You will get used to it. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he didn't want that people will, that's why Hashem said to Aaron HaKohen, Ve'al yavo b'chol et el HaKodesh. Hashem said to him, Aaron, what happened to your children? Don't do it. You go there only once a year, on Kippur. Because if you go every day you go inside the Kodesh HaKodeshim, you bring the Ketoret there, you will get used to it. So Yom Kippur, you will not do a good tefillah. So prepare yourself all year for Yom Kippur. Hashem, it teaches us how to control ourselves and how to be far away from getting used to things. That's what the Torah in Parashat Ekev, V'haya Ekev Tishmi'un. Rashi Ala Makom, he said, what the meaning of V'haya Ekev Tishmi'un? Be careful from the mitzvot that you are used to do every time. Because you do them every time, so you get used to them. And if you get used to them, so you will not do them with perfection. Now, my friend, we understand to appreciate what Hashem created so Hashem give us Shabbat. Otherwise, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, okay, we'll get used to it, and there will be no Havdalah, nothing to separate from Hol and Kodesh. There will be nothing to separate that. So we will be doing, you know, even our emunah will be light. So Akash Chigivah Shabbat, different. That all the week, the 6 day week, they get the bracha from Shabbat. What do you do Shabbat? You don't work. What do you do Shabbat? You rest. What do you do Shabbat? You do the Torah. What do you do Shabbat? Shabbat is Me'en Olam Haba. At least you test a little bit of Olam Haba on Shabbat. But if you have Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, you will never test what this is Olam Haba. You will never appreciate what this is Olam Haba. You will never appreciate nothing. So I can show you once a week, Shabbat. Shabbat, it makes a big difference between the rest of the week. So you start the week again after Shabbat, after being in your house, in the shul, on Shabbat. So you start the 6 day week with big emunah kashko. Because the Kedusha, the influence of Shabbat, it will help you during the whole week. So you say, Rabotai, this is, my friend, unfortunately, for those who live in Israel, they had one of the biggest tzaddikim of all time, not far from them. And every time, and just now that he passed away, last week we were maybe a million people in his levaya. It's something that you cannot imagine what kind of levaya it was. You will never see that. To nobody, only a man of Torah, only a man who was connected so much to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He had this zichut to have this kind of levaya. All the Gedolei Ador, everybody was there. Everybody was there. And you know, you could be even 2 million people. It's just the police stopped all the road. But you cannot go. You cannot go. My friend, unfortunately, we got used to it. Hey, he's here. He's next door. This is Rabotai, the danger. The danger that you feel is he lives in the next door. Okay, he's there. Rabotai, today we talk a lot about Mashiach, but today it becomes very light, Mashiach. Why? Because all the time we talk about him, and because he didn't come. No, maybe one day will come. For the moment, we disconnect ourselves. And this is the problem. The Rambam says, be careful. Even that he didn't come in the Shua, he didn't come for 2,000 years. We wait for him. He didn't come. Wait for him like this is the first time that we give you the news. Hey, Mashiach is going to come. Really? Yes, he's going to come. Otherwise, when you get used to it, you become cold of it. The Torah said, Kabil et avicha v'itimecha. Lema'an ya'arichun yamecha. Respect your father and mother, so you have a long life. Why? Why long life? Because it's a reward that Hashem give you. Because your father and mother, you get used to them. You see them every time. So, you think you respect them, but maybe you don't respect him. You know what it is, respect your father and mother. Every time you see your father, you have to stand up. Do we do that? No. There is a halacha. If you hear your mother calling your father, hey, Moshe, because only you heard her voice, you have to stand up. Do we do that? No. Why? Because we get used to it. And that's why Hashem gives a reward. You do as the halacha wants you to do for the respect of your father and mother, so you have long life. My friend, that's what happened to Nadav Avihu. Nadav Avihu, they were big tzaddikim. But they wanted to go every time they want to the Kodesh HaKodashim. I know. If you go every time you want to the Kodesh HaKodashim, you will not feel it as you should feel it. It will be like light. You will not. So the Hashem said, no, basta, stop. You cannot go to the Kodesh HaKodashim in the moment you want. Only once a year. That's it. I finished with David HaMelech. David HaMelech, alav shalom, he said, "Ahad sha'alti me'et Hashem otahat avakesh." One thing I ask from Hashem. One thing. Not money. Not glory. Not enemies. One thing. What? Shifti be'et Hashem. I want to stay in the yeshiva. But not only to stay in the yeshiva. Hashem, help me that I will not get used of sitting in the yeshiva. Shifti be'et Hashem. L'chazot ben. So I can feel you, Hashem, ulbaker, and ulbaker ve'chalo. And every time I come, it's like a bikur, it's like a visit. Like somebody will visit the doctor. You don't call it every day. It's a visit. He has an appointment. It's like Hashem, David HaMelech said, Hashem, help me, that every time I come to the synagogue, it's like an appointment that I have with you. And when you have an appointment with somebody important, you are excited. You are very excited. So that's what David HaMelech alav shalom, he asked from David, from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Rabotai, this is Rabotai, the parasha of the week. Here at some today is the 7 days of the tzaddik of Rav Chaim Kanievsky alav shalom. Do you know that Rav Chaim Kanievsky, if you go to see him, you have to take your watch from your hand. You are not allowed to have it. If you see a watch in your hand, he will tell you, are you a woman? For him, only ladies can watch. But I said this week, Chas v'chalila, that he must have another reason. And I think the reason that he had, and he was against the watch, because the watch, we are connected to the watch. Because we want to know what time is it, how long I'm going to study. The watch, when you're born with no watch. When it comes to Avodat Hashem, the watch doesn't exist. To know what time you have to fly, you can ask, what time you work? But when it comes to Avodat Hashem, today, everybody is watching the watch. What I finish, what I start, da 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 da. So you become the slave of the watch. And that's why, Rabotai, with Hashem, there is no limit. Do Hashem give you time? Do Hashem, Chas v'chalila, work with you with the time? Kadosh Baruch Hu give you all the time you need. The same way that Hashem, he doesn't do business with you for all the time that he gives you, so you as well, you have to give time to HaKadosh Baruch Hu without limiting the time. This is what I was thinking about Rav Chaim Kanievsky. She's Chutzot Tagen Aleichem, Amen.